Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I want to show you a holster I got for my Smith X-Frame with a 3.5-inch barrel. Now, in my previous video I just did, I showed you guys a pancake style holster for this revolver. So in this video, I want to show you a chest holster or chest rig that's made specifically for this revolver. Now, this chest holster is made by a company called Diamond D Leather, and these are made out in Alaska. So that's pretty cool. And guys, I feel that if you want to try to carry an X frame or a big bore revolver like a Ruger, what have you, or even a big bore pistol like a Desert Eagle, I feel they are best served carried in a chest holster. Now, I know a lot of you guys watching this video probably don't have a need for this type of system, but I figure I'd do this video anyways to, you know, show you what this thing looks like, how it works, for entertainment purposes and for curiosity's sake. So, basically, a chest holster serves a specific role, application, and environment. All right. Me personally, what I'm using this for, a chest holster is most likely going to be openly carried. All right. So I don't know what state you guys are from, but in this state where I'm at, it's anti-gun. They're trying to ban every type of firearm you can imagine, ammunition, what have you. They're trying to take away the rights, whatever, blah, blah, blah. So it's not really appropriate to openly carry. However, I'm using the system on my own property, in my own woods. If I'm going hiking with the guys, we're going hiking out on private property. So we are not gonna run into anybody else out there. So it's appropriate to open carry, all right? But let's just say, hypothetically, if I were to use this system, and I don't know why I'd be doing this, but if I were to walk in the streets or in a parking lot, or better yet, if I'm on the outskirts of private property and there's a busy road, and there are people driving by, all right, and they see me carrying the system, and they don't see me in a uniform or any type of badge on my person, you can best bet they're calling 911, and they're going to have the cops, you know, called on me, come down and detain me, and talk to me, and blah, blah, possibly charge, you know, be charged with breach of peace and disorderly conduct. I mean, that's what happens here. You know, that's how it is. There's a guy I'm talking to out in Wyoming. I mean, this guy carries a 460V, a 5-inch barrel version one, in the same type of rig by Diamond D Leather, and he's able to hike in the forest, pass by other hikers. Nobody bats an eye. No one freaks out. He's able to go into town, go into the diner with this system on him, with his 460V, sit down, order some breakfast, you know, look at his iPhone, read up some articles, what have you. Nobody bats an eye. You know, someone else will come in carrying a gun openly, and it's acceptable. No one freaks out, falling to their knees, screaming, "Oh my God, help me!" That's just how it is in his state, and I'm jealous. It's like a free state. They can do whatever they want. They can be in open land and start plinking if they'd like to, safely, of course. It's just amazing. It's just a totally different world, and yeah, more power to him. That's awesome. As an example, let me just tell you this story here. There's a guy you know. From the range, you know, he's got long hair, he's got a big beard, he's kind of scruffy looking, but he's a very intelligent individual. He's actually like an aerospace type engineer of some sort, and he openly carries. You know, he tries to make a point. He's for our rights, pro Second Amendment, you know, for this state here, you know. And he told me one time he went into a Wendy's, I think it was, or something, to get lunch. Open carrying his 1911, which is a Wilson Combat. And there was, I guess, a woman behind him with her child. And she started getting all scared and like, "Oh my God, I don't know if he's a cop. Oh my God." And she walked out of the Wendy's. And before you know it, cops show up. They come in, talk to him. He wasn't charged with anything, but they kind of told him, "Hey, listen, you know, after everything checked out." She's like, "Yeah, we understand you mean well. You know, you're not a threat. But you may want to cover that up." You know, they gave him the breach of peace and disorderly conduct spiel. So I believe he complied because he didn't want to make a big deal out of it right there. So that's what happens here. So we can't really open carry. Technically we can, but it's not advised to because people around here aren't used to that. You know, they freak out. Anyways, let's get back on track here. Let me show you this holster. So again, this is made by a company called Diamond D Leather. It's called the Guide's Choice. I picked this chest holster because of all the stuff I found on YouTube. There's so many videos about this rig on YouTube, plenty of reviews. I'm not really going to review this, I'm just going to talk about it. If you really want to see a review, hey, just look it up on YouTube, there's plenty of them. So I went with them. There are other companies out there that make chest holsters, but I like what I saw on this Guide's Choice by Diamond D Leather. Basically, you know, it took about a month to get. It is an expensive rig, I'll say that. So if you really have no purpose for this, just move along, nothing to see. I wouldn't buy it. But for me personally, I have a purpose for it. And that's why I got it. But it is somewhat expensive. But I feel it's well worth the money because I see quality. The leather, you know, high quality. The way it's stitched together, the way it's assembled. I see quality and it works out very well. So let's put this revolver in the holster so you guys can see what it looks like. It's kind of funny here. Every time I open this cylinder up, it's just so massive. when I first got this holster, I could not put this revolver in here. It was so tight, it definitely needed it to be broken in. So it still kind of needs to be broken in, but let's just put it in there so we can show you what it looks like. It goes right in just like that. Fits very nicely. It's molded exactly for this revolver. The only downside though, let me show you this, is that when I was trying to break in this holster, I kept putting the revolver in and out, in and out. This massive cylinder here kept hitting up against the holster right about there. Okay, see that? See that? And as you can see, the leather is tearing right about there. If that continues to happen and goes through that stitching, we may have a problem, but I don't think so. I think this is just cosmetic. But that's the only thing that's been going on, is it's kind of tearing up the leather right about there where the cylinder is knocking up against it. So, oh well, what are you going to do? So I have it like this. I've carried it out into the woods all week long. I've gone through pricker bushes, so the prickers have been cutting it up all around, you know, on the leather. But you know, there's a mark right there and here. But I mean, this is a outdoors type of system, so it's going to get beat up. So we'll see how it's lasts, you know, through the test of time there, you know. So, very high quality. The back looks like this. The connections, top notch, all right? So, it's a pretty nice system. Stitching is very well done. You can support this weight with this strap here, not a problem. You can control the tension by, you know, adjusting that screw, but I find that the holster itself has plenty of retention. It comes with this hammer thong here, so I don't know if this is just for looks, but I guess you can just put it on like that. Place just like that, and I guess in theory it's not going to fall out, but guys, this molding is so tight, there's no way this thing's just going to fall right out. But you got this extra little bit of security if need be, I guess. But I don't use it when I'm out in the woods, so I just leave it like this. I did get the loop loader sewn onto the shoulder strap right here because I thought it's a nice touch and a pretty cool option. You can put another 5 rounds, okay, just like that. Here, let me put some rounds in there. So I'll put some 460s in here just like that, go like that. And guys, this system isn't made to be quick in a way. It's more about accessibility. You know, you got the holster right in front of you on your chest, so if you need be, I guess you can access this and do what you really have to do. This is not made for a situation where you're encountering, let's say, a feral being where you got to draw this really quickly and take care of business. All right, this is for you guys know, I'm not going to repeat myself, but animal defense. So even trying to reload from this loop loader, it's going to be very slow. But again, the application is totally different than on the streets. And I'm not going to get into like all the animal defense type stuff. You guys can let me know what you think about all that. But I do find that the system works very well. Like I said, I've been using it all week long and I like it. It works very well. It's just pricey, and you really need to know what you want this for, or what are you going to use it for. The strap is adjustable, so you can adjust it if need be. But I guess that's all you really want to say. So you got 460, 460, 460. You got a 454 and a 45 Colt right there. So guys, why don't I show you what this looks like on my person, and you guys can let me know what you think. But yeah, it's a pretty nice system. All right, let's get going. I'll show you what this looks like on my person. So let's check out what this chest holster looks like on my person. You know, I was actually outside in the woods trying to do this, just to give you a little bit different background. But unfortunately, because it's so windy today, the camera on the tripod fell over a bunch of times. And then when I finally got it in position, did the video, I went back to, you know, replay it. All you can hear is wind. And then you can hear me talking, then wind. And it wasn't focusing correctly because of the sun was coming this way. So I came back inside. Let's redo this. Let's do this proper so you can see what it looks like and hear me. All right, so this chest holster, how do you put this thing on? It's very simple. Just take this shoulder strap, open it up just like that, and put your arm through it. Okay, and that's it. That's that simple. So it kind of looks like this. And then find the back strap. It's going to be a black one right here. Okay, and this is going to plug into this buckle right here. So it's very simple. Locked in place. Now adjust the chest holster and then take the slack out like that. Just pull on this. Take the slack out and just want to adjust it. Take the slack out and there you go. So basically the chest holster is in place and it's ready to go. So let me take out my X-frame out of the pocket holster I got here for this 460. Yeah, right. I'm just kidding, guys. Just kidding. Okay. And let me just insert the revolver in the holster. And that's how it looks. Very, very nice. I like it a lot. That's what the back straps look like, right? And this is how this chest holster looks. Very nice. The weight is evenly distributed, so the revolver lies flat right on your chest. And in this angle, you can walk around. You want to wear a backpack, you can. If you want to wear something on the belt line, you can. And this beats carrying something like this on the strong side hip, definitely. This is the way to go. So I'll be walking on private property in the woods with this rig just like this. And it works out very well. And if there was a situation where I had to draw this, I would have to hold the holster like this, grab the grip, and then draw and do what I have to do. If I had to reload, again, this is not for speed, this is more for access. Had to reload, punch out those casings. I can grab a 460 off the loop loader like this and then drop it into the cylinder like that. Again, it's not gonna be really quick, but you have extra spare ammo at your disposal right up here. So we're gonna take those out, make sure this is clear. Okay, and that's it. I'll just reholster and I'm set, ready to go. I really like this system. I think it works out very, very well. It feels good, but again, you really need to have a need for this type of system because it's a pricey type of setup and it's not something you're just gonna buy just to have, you know? So you need to have some type of purpose for this. And I'll be going out into the woods on private property with this on me, just like this, and it works out very well. And like I said, guys, the only downside was this part of the holster right here. I showed it to you in the beginning of the video, is where the leather was kind of breaking up because of this massive cylinder always hitting up against it. So it's like kind of ripping up the leather right here. I don't know, we'll see what happens. It shouldn't be a problem, but that's it, guys. This is how it looks. I like it a lot. I think it's a great system. So if you have any questions or comments, let me know. And I guess that's about it. So as always, guys, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.